अस्सलाम वालेकुम ग्रेड 5, टुडे इज़ आवर सेकेंड लेक्चर एंड इट्स अबाउट डेटा डिवाइसेस। सो देर आर बेसिकली टू टाइप ऑफ डेटा डिवाइसेस। वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड इन ग्रेड 4, द वन इज इनपुट डिवाइसेस एंड द अनदर वन इज आउटपुट डिवाइसेस। फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस इनपुट डिवाइसेस। इनपुट डिवाइसेस, द डिवाइस थ्रू विच द डाटा एंड इंस्ट्रक्शंस आर फेड इनटू अ कंप्यूटर आर कॉल्ड इनपुट डिवाइसेस। An input device convert data and instructions into electrical signals that can be recognized by the computer. You have already learned about the input devices such as keyboard, mouse, trackball, joystick, light pen, scanner, web camera, digital camera and microphone in class 4. Let us now learn about two more of these devices, the graphic tablet and the touch screen. Number one, we have graphic tablets. A graphic tablet is an input device that enables a user to draw image by hand, similar to the way a person draw image via pencil on paper. It consists of a flat surface on which the user may write a word or draw an image using a special pen called stylus. You can see in the image down. The image generally does not appear on the tablet itself, but it is displayed on the computer monitor. These tablets are commonly used by graphic designer, illustrator and artist. So basically आप जो कुछ भी बनाते हैं इस graphic tablet के ऊपर, तो वो generally हमें नज़र नहीं आता, लेकिन उसकी जो output होती है वो हमें monitor पे show हो रहा होता है। Second, we have touch screen. A touch screen is a computer display screen that recognizes touch input. Basically touch screen takes your touch as an input. A user interacts with the computer by touching words or pictures on the screen. Some examples of touch screens are ATM and tablet PC. So basically touch screens are used in ATM machines and tablet PCs. Now we'll discuss the output component of computer. The device that are used to get the output from a computer are called output devices. Now you have already learned about the following output devices in grade 4, like visual display units known as VDU, speaker, headphones, projectors and printers. But today we'll discuss some types of printers. So printers, there are two types of printer, impact printer and non-impact printer. But before we discuss impact and non-impact printer, let me tell you some background of a printer. A printer provides output in a permanent readable form on a physical medium like paper or transparent film. The printed output is called the hard copy. Printers are of two main types, impact printer and non-impact printer. Impact printer. In an impact printer, a print head strikes an ink ribbon, which in turn strikes the paper to mark on the paper. This means that there is a mechanical contact between the print head and the paper. Example are dot matrix, daisy wheel and line printers. So here you can see the examples of printer. We have daisy wheel, line printer and dot matrix printer. Now non-impact printer. In this type of printer, there is no mechanical contact between the print head and the paper. Examples are inkjet printer and laser printer. Inkjet printer. So before I jump into the inkjet printer, let me tell you one thing, that impact printers were being replaced by non-impact printers. The examples of non-impact printers are inkjet and laser jet. So inkjet and inkjet printer, the printer head sprays extremely small droplets of ink on the paper to form the desired character or image that you want to print. It is faster and has better printing quality than a dot matrix printer. However, the printout has a tendency to smear if it gets wet. Now, laser printer. In a laser printer, a laser beam, a dense beam of light, produces an image of the desired character on a drum called a roller. The roller passes through a powdered ink called toner. The toner sticks to the parts of the drum that were hit by the laser beam. Finally, the characters are transferred to the paper through a combination of heat and pressure. A laser printer is very fast and produces high quality printouts. Then memory. The storage capacity of a computer is called its memory. Memory enables the computer to store data, instructions, and information. Now, data. Data are facts, figures, words, etc. that we want the computer to work on. Then instructions. Instructions are the commands that tells the computer how to work on the given data. Then on third we have information. Information is the result or output given by the computer. Then we have binary digits. A computer works with only two digits, 0 and 1. The data input to the computer is first converted into zeros and ones for the computer to understand them. Basically, computer understand the language of zeros and ones. These digits are called binary digits or bits. A bit is the smallest chunk of information a computer can work with. Now, combination of 8 bit is equal to 1 byte. I'll explain it in the coming slide. Now, in this table, I'll show you the higher units of memory. So, 1 kilobyte is equal to 1024 bytes. Now, 1 megabyte is equal to 1024 kilobytes. Then, 1 gigabyte is equal to 1024 megabyte. 1 terabyte is equal to 1024 gigabyte. Then same, 1 petabyte is equal to 1024 terabyte, and so on. Then types of memory. Computer memory can be classified into three types, namely primary memory, read-only memory known as ROM, and secondary memory. So here you can see computer memory is divided into three categories. Then primary memory is further divided into one category that is called random access memory, RAM. And secondary memory is categorized into floppy disk, hard disk, CD, DVD, Blu-ray disc, and flash drives. We'll discuss it briefly in the coming slides. Now, primary memory. Primary memory is also called internal memory and is the main area in a computer where data, instruction, and information is stored. This can be directly accessed by the CPU. The CPU accesses the memory in a random manner called RAM, random access memory. The CPU can access data from RAM only till the computer is switched on. As soon as the power to the computer is switched off, the stored data and instruction disappear from RAM. This kind of memory is called volatile memory. Now ROM. ROM is a memory from which usually the information can only be read. This information can also be directly accessed by the CPU, but the data and instructions stored in ROM are retained even when the computer is switched off. This kind of memory is called non-volatile. मतलब ROM में जो आपका डाटा और इंस्ट्रक्शन है वो एज इट इज ही रहेंगे इवन दो कंप्यूटर आपका स्विच ऑफ भी रहे. नाउ इन लास्ट वील डिस्कस सेकेंडरी मेमरी. प्राइमरी मेमरी इज वॉलेटाइल एंड हैज लिमिटेड कैपेसिटी. सो इट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट टू हैव सम अदर फॉर्म ऑफ मेमरी ऑन विच डाटा एंड प्रोग्राम्स कैन बी स्टोर्ड इवन वेन द कंप्यूटर इज टर्न ऑफ. सो सेकेंडरी मेमरी ऑल्सो नोन एज एक्सटर्नल मेमरी इज वेयर प्रोग्राम्स and data are stored for future referencing. It is also called auxiliary memory. Secondary devices have much large storage capacity. Examples are floppy disks, hard disks, CDs, DVDs, Blu-ray discs, and flash drive. We'll discuss their storage capacity. Now, their storage capacity. So, floppy disk. Its storage size is 1.44 MB. Hard disk, it comes in different storage capacity. For example, it can be 320 GB or it can be 500 GB or it can be 1 TB or 2 TB, etc. Now CD-ROM, it can store up to 700 MB data. DVD, CD and Blu-ray are all CDs, but they have different capacity of storage. Now DVD, it can store up to 4.7 GB data. Blu-ray disk, It can store up to 25 GB data. In the last flash drive, it comes in different various capacities. For example, 16 GB, 32 GB, 64 GB, 128 GB and so on. These are some examples of secondary storage. As you can see in the first row, DVD, CD, Blu-ray disc, all are same but their storage capacity are different. Like a simple CD, the storage capacity is 700 MB, a DVD storage capacity is 4.7 GB and the Blu-ray disc capacity is 25 GB. Now you can see hard disk, floppy disk and a USB. So this was all about today's lecture. I hope this was easy for you guys to differentiate between the storage capacities of different components. See you in next slide inshallah. Thank you.